to allow our individual motions and into the target area. This is accomplished by pulling down on the turn and slowing down at speeds of up to 60 miles per hour. This allows the set of a traffic pattern just like you find the aircraft at an airport. You may notice this first parachute is colored differently than the others. This is our team leader leading in the staff. At 1,000 feet, the jumper does what is called a wind penetration check, checking his speed and distance across the ground. He will then fly at a downwind level, a base leg 9 degrees throughout him, and then face into the wind for a final approach. It takes a great deal of concentration in order to land dead center on the target. The jumper keeps a close eye on the windsock located in the target area. One final approach, he then shifts all his concentration to a small black dot located in the center of the RTX. And your team leader is, with a beautiful dead center landing. Flying our POW-MIA flag, here comes Sergeant First Class Danny Hill, bringing it into the landing area. Watch the movement he makes to attend another dead center landing.
Let's go. possibility of getting shot down. We call this a guns jig. Performance. Those gray, white, and blue stripes you see on each aircraft are like you to learn a little bit more about their sponsor.
Ladies and gentlemen. competitions. In fact, Michael has flown on three U.S. World Aerobatic teams and is a past U.S. Today, he is one of the best airshow flyers in the world and one of only seven aviators who have received all three of the airshow industry's top awards. Michael is also one of an elite group of pilots who won the Red Bull Air Race World Championship. This mind-blowing race of speed and agility plays out in amazing cities around the globe each summer. Only a few individuals have enjoyed the success that Michael has had airshow industry, and he feels incredibly lucky and honored to be able to make a living flying aerial displays for incredible fans like you. All of these aircraft are sponsored by Cockpit USA, makers of the Made in USA finely crafted flight jackets and aviation and heritage inspired apparel for over 45 years. And the North American Texan trainer. Cockpit USA is the company that brought the A2 back to the Air Force in 1987. The flight jackets and wires of the U.S. Air Force for 30 years and also supplied aviators from the United States Navy, the Coast Guard, the Army, and Allied Air Forces for over 30 years. Also used at Long Island's regional for helping change the course of the war, particularly with respect to the survivability of the big, heavy bombers that launched from bases in England during World War II to bomb during the daylight bombing raids over German Hill. We'll tell you more about that in a minute. In front of us, the C-47 with the stripes on it. Those were called invasion stripes on the huge attack on German-held Normandy, France on June 6, 1944. Those stripes were painted on all Allied aircraft so that we wouldn't shoot our own guys down. Following it, the North American advanced trainer, the Texan. Listen to the difference in the sound here. Airliners were turned into cargo haulers, hospital call. And the cargo plane that helped change the course of the war. As a matter of fact, it states, called the C-47 one of the most important weapons of World War II, even though it did not carry any armament. The Avenger out front, followed by a single-person life raft bobbing around in the Pacific until it was rescued by an American rescue submarine. Of these aircraft were built, depending on whose history book you read. And by the way, if your history book says differently than the numbers that I might give Great Britain to perform those daring daylight raids in Europe. But the bomber crews had to face the fear, the flak, the fighters, and the fire being thrown at them by the Luftwaffe. So these little friends, these Mustangs like we see here,
sensors help mask the engine heat signature, aiding the pilot to defeat infrared missiles. Let's go to the cockpit, the A-10.
Airframe, the X5 portal, allows it to do maneuvers that sometimes
forcing the turn the other. He hangs it on the prop. All the controls are reversed. Left is right is left, forward is back, back is forward. He's backwards, 400, 500, 500. He's got about 550 or 600 feet backwards. Side. So he comes across the top with a half a roll and over the top, half a roll, watch him pull 45, a half a roll, a push 45 degrees for side six, a half a roll, pull 45 for side eight. Let those engine temperatures cool.
Thank you.
Major Dick Cavendish with twin captains.
match the precision required to maneuver six F-16s as one formation. Let that serve as a reminder of not just the teamwork, but also the dedication and commitment that makes our team and the United States Air Force the most capable and incredible force on the planet.
Airmen who are deployed around